in case anybody didn't know, my name is Trombone Shorty, all the way from the great city of New Orleans. Who that?
I got the name Trombone Shorty because the instrument was much taller than I was when I was young. I started playing when I was 4. And the trombone was much taller at that moment. And my brother James Andrews is a trumpet player who's responsible for me playing. He gave me the name at a jazz funeral. And it's been stuck with me since. I'm from the Tremé neighborhood, which is the oldest black neighborhood in America, and it's where jazz and brass band music was created, and I happen to be one of the last people out of there. It's an amazing neighborhood full of music, and it's responsible for me today in the way that I play and everything that I've been exposed to. Tremé had a big impact because all those people were there playing when I was a kid, marching around, and I was able to join in with them and get the real life experience. My music, super funk rock, is just a musical gumbo. It's a direct influence of New Orleans. New Orleans has, we're genreless in New Orleans, so we don't really know what to call our music besides New Orleans music. It's a great place to be. It's one of the only cities you could probably hang out with the Marcellus family, the Neville brothers, or whoever it may be, and all of us play together. Everybody should know where the music comes from. Whatever style of music it is you're playing, you should know a little bit of history about it so you can know where you want to go. But I don't know if it's a responsibility, because I feel like music should be pushed forward. So 50 years from now, if my music becomes the standard to some young kids or something, I'm not expecting them to keep it alive or anything. I'm just expecting them to learn from what I've done and take it and push it towards what they're doing, because sometimes people get caught up into trying to recreate something, and that actually hurts the genre of music because there's nothing new. So I think it's up to the young people to learn and respect where it comes from and understand the history and the lifeline or the timeline of it and learn from that and take it for what it was. Because some of the older musicians back in the day, they were pushing forward. I mean, Louis Armstrong did what he did, and Miles Davis sound nothing like him. So music was always trying to go forward. What type of setting I'm in. It's just fun New Orleans music with a different twist on it. It's exciting.